My name is Roberto Zenit. I'm a professor of engineering. My specialty is fluid mechanics. I would consider myself a bubble expert. I discovered that the artisans that make mezcal, at least back in the day, they would foam up the mezcal and observe if the bubbles remain floating for some time. They took that as an indication of the correct amount of ethanol in the distilled spirit. It was impossible for me not to investigate why was this the case. We took mezcal to the lab and ran experiments to measure with precision the life of bubbles in these liquids. The reason why a bubble at this intermediate concentration of ethanol is capable of remaining alive, remaining floating without bursting for some time, is a result of all the other components that are present in mezcal. So some of these compounds are of the type called surfactants. Like soap is a surfactant. Of course, soap is not present in mezcal, but it's just a generic name of these molecules that like to attach to the surfaces of liquids. So these molecules have the property to change the surface tension. So the bubble comes to the surface, then you have a lot of surfactant molecules here and not so many here. So that induces an upward flow. That's called the Marangoni flow. Gravity is doing its things, pushing it down, and the Marangoni flow is replenishing the fluid that is in the film. That's why it lasts for much longer. By doing this experiment with this alcoholic drink, we learned something. We learned that you need to have certain properties of the mixture of ethanol and water, and you need to have the presence of surfactants in order to achieve this long duration, long life of bubbles, right? One of the things that is also interesting to me, at least, is that mezcal is a very typical drink made in Mexico, where I'm from. So it just gives me a little bit of additional pleasure to work on something that has cultural value for my ancestors and for me.